One of the most common mistakes that the GMAT test takers make is they focus on one area too much. For example, studying quantum for a month and then studying verbal for the next month is not a good study plan. You need to tackle both quantum and verbal at the same time to maximize your study efficiency. In this video, we discuss practical strategies you can apply when studying for the GMAT, plus the meaningful statistics offered by the GMAC. Studying the GMAT for 2 months is what GMAC, the official GMAT testing organization, recommends. They even have 8-week study plan in PDF. I have put the link below in the description, so check them out. An effective study plan for the GMAT is outlined like this. First, be familiar with the GMAT structure. Explore every part of the GMAT: analytical writing assessment, integral reasoning, data sufficiency, reading comprehension, sentence correction, critical reasoning. And then, explore the topics of the GMAT in quantum verbal. For example, in quantitative section, you have arithmetic, algebra, geometry, and word problems. For detailed topics, I have a free PDF file at cognifygmat.com, so please check the link below in the description. Make sure to visit the webpage and download it. After you become familiar with the structures and topics, the next step is very critical. Assess yourself. There is a diagnostic test in the GMAT official guide, so make sure to solve it. There are about 50 questions for quant and another 50 questions for verbal diagnostic test. I recommend taking the free online practice exam, GMAT Prep, after studying about 2 weeks. If you repeat the practice exam 1 from GMAT Prep, it will be likely that you will get the same question. You don't want to wait to practice exam, so it is best to use the GMAT Prep after you become familiar with the GMAT structure and content. Therefore, the diagnostic test in the GMAT official guide is an excellent introductory tool for assessing your weak areas. After assessing yourself with the diagnostic test, the third step is plan your study. How long can you actually afford to study every day? 2 hours? 3 hours? It is best to keep up the pace with 3 hours study time every day. The actual study time then will be a minimum of 2 hours. Some people study 1 hour in the morning and then 2 hours in the evening. If you are involved with volunteering and social life and can't cut them down, you should consider studying more than 3 months and study in small chunks. The general rule is, you should study more than 100 hours, preferably 120 to 150 hours. Solve all problems in the official guide. Do all 3 books of the GMAT official guide series. In total, there are 404 quantitative questions in official guide 2019, and there are 403 verbal questions in OG 2019. The OG quant review has 300 quant questions, and the verbal review has 301 questions. In whole, you have 704 quant questions and another 704 verbal questions for all official guide books. That's 1,508 questions, including the diagnostic test. And if you spend an average of 5 minutes for each question, you will need a minimum of 125 hours of study time. Of course, you don't have to solve any outright easy question, but you can see that studying all 3 official guides consumed lots of time. Also, another important thing is that always study at the same time for quantum verbal problems. Don't focus on one area too much. Make sure to cover all topics, both verbal and quant. There are several ways to do this. Some people study the verbal in the morning before work and study quant in the evening. Some people study verbal and quant for each alternating days, like Monday verbal, Tuesday quant, Wednesday verbal, and so on. Make sure you take 1 day off in a week for a break. Taking a break is very important to keep up your pace. The fourth step is always review progress. Just solving lots of problems is not a good studying strategy. It's all about self-awareness. Cognize by yourself. So, always take a note of weak areas and review a list. If you find a particular question difficult or make a stupid mistake, take note of it. Never ever underestimate your mistakes. It is the best if you begin reviewing your weak areas in the second month of your study. The fifth step is take practice exams. Taking the actual exam is hard. It's all about stamina and focus. Can you withstand 3 hours straight problem solving? To keep your pace well on the actual test, it's important to take practice exams. I recommend buying practice exams 3 and 4, which is $50 for simulating the actual GMAT. The last step is practice time management. A lot of test takers skip this step, but this step is crucial. Which type of questions do you spend the most time? Which type of questions can you shorten time and solve quickly? What should you do when you are about to run out of time? How do you manage your guessing strategy? Time your problem solving, and if you can solve it within 2 minutes on average, you are in good shape. Now, let us look at the statistics offered by the GMAT. According to 2017 Prospective Students Survey, the median study hours for each continent is as follows. Please note that this is the median study hours, not the average. Median means the middle number. Most countries study for the GMAT for about 2 months. It is interesting to note that while the median study hours for the United States is 48 hours, European and Asian countries tend to have double the amount of median study time, around 90 and 100 study hours. This indicates that for most people whose first language is not English, it takes time to study the verbal part. There's another statistic from 2017 Prospective Students Survey. The GMAT surveyed more than 4,300 people and found that the test score in general is proportional to the amount of study hours you put into. You can see that there are lots of people who spend more than 90 hours and get over 700. Again, this number is median, so just use it as a reference. Finally, the GMAT surveyed more than 4,500 test takers and asked the hours spent preparing for the GMAT. The result is interesting. Regardless of the scores, the amount of study time people put into it is nearly identical for all categories. However, you can notice that there are more people studying over 50 hours than those who study less than 50 hours. About 55% of test takers study more than 50 hours. What is the meaning of all these statistics? Don't compare yourself with others when it comes to studying the GMAT. Everyone has different skill sets and different available study time. Know your own context and situation. Some people take more than 6 months to study, and it's not something to be embarrassed about. However, the general rule is, it usually takes at least 2 months to prepare, and a good 100 hours study time is required for most people. So you can see that your own customized study plan, along with keeping an error log to review your weaknesses, is a key to the successful GMAT studying. Don't forget to download the PDF file for the detailed GMAT study topic. Comment of the day! Are there any good study strategies you want to share? Please leave the comment below and also subscribe to the channel and like the video. Thank you and good luck with studying.